And today we have Manuela Osorio in EE's show.
Hello guys, my name is Manuela Osorio and welcome to a new episode of EE's show. Today we're going to present you the company of Bimbo.
Backed with goodness and baked with love, that's what Bimbo bread is made of. Isn't it nice to know, slice by slice, that something nutritious can be so delicious too?
It started with only 34 employees, 14 products, and only 10 trucks, and now is one of the largest baking companies of the world. Its products include breads and its derivatives, cookies, candy, chocolates, sweet and salty snacks, and a lot of products. 2017, the company has more than 137,000 employees and 195 manufacturing plants. It is present in America, Europe, Asia, and Africa, and it manufactures more than 13,000 products. Okay guys, and now I'm going to present you two special guests that we have today in our program, and one surprise.
Disculpa, ¿me puedes dar un autógrafo para mi hijo? ¿Y cuando tocan? ¿Tú eres el cantante este, el de... ¿No? ¿No? ¡Ah, no! ¡Eres John Harriman! ¡El de la serie de vampiros! ¿No?
No.
Messi. Basquetbolista.
¿Tampoco?
¡Ay! ¿Pan blanco Bimbo con leche? Es el mismo que le compro a mi hijo. Él también necesita crecer. ¡Wow! ¿A qué te dedicas?
No importa que no sepa quién es Lionel Messi. Lo que importa es que sepa qué hace grande a tu hijo.
Disculpa, ¿me das un autógrafo? Eres la de comercial.
¿Qué comercial?
De la Echeleche.
¡Ah, el del basquetbolista!
¿Sí?
¡Claro! ¿Cómo te llamas?
Cristiano.
Para... Cristiano. Pan blanco Bimbo con actileche. Es el mismo que le compró a mi hijo. Ay, tú no necesitas crecer. De hecho, te ves muy bien. Yo podría hacerte famoso.
Mi nueva asesora de imagen.
Cuando alimentas a tus hijos con actileche, no solo ellos crecen, tú también. Pan blanco Bimbo con actileche.
I'm with Laura Rosco, the head of marketing of Bimbo. Okay, so welcome guys.
Thank you for this invitation. We're really happy to be here and we hope we can contribute you with our information about this.
Thank you very much. Okay, so Juan, tell me a little bit which is the target market of Bimbo.
Okay, so Bimbo's main target market are young people, young adults, children, whoever wants to try our product and just like be satisfied with it.
Okay, and Laura, tell me a little bit about the market needs of Bimbo.
Okay, so our market and its needs is very different in every country because it's all about the culture and what people like in each culture. So, for example, we had an experience with China that we wanted to enter to China with our products without changing anything. So what happened was that they didn't like these like sugar leaf flavors.
Okay.
So we have to create new products and we create things salty, for example, cucumber bread and things like that.
And Juan, what about the market needs of USA?
Okay, so the situation in the USA is what the consumers were demanding products with less trans fat and less overall fat. And more like organic type of food. So what we did is we changed our strategy and we decided to replace the products for more healthier ones.
Okay.
And it worked.
Okay. And Laura, I would like to know about the goals that Bimbo has.
We have a lot of goals, and one of them is to be one of the company of Latin America to enter to the Chinese market, and also to have a strong presence in United States, and a presence that is also connected with profitability.
Okay, thank you very much. And now, guys, we have a surprise for you. We are in a video call with your partner, Ana Sofía Lara, in the headquarters of Mexico. And she's with my partner, Camila Bejarano, and we are going to ask her some questions.
En Bimbo queremos decirte algo.
¿A mí?
Bueno, a ti y a todos los que os gusta comer pan. Con las manos o con los ojos, da igual.
Ah, vale.
Esto es para el que un día es más de salado, otro más de dulce, y para los que se duermen todos los lunes.
Bueno, no todos.
También para los que se visten así, los que se visten asá, para los locos de las salsas, los impacientes que se queman. Y por supuesto, los cantantes, bailarines, los que se portan bien, los que se portan mal, los que gritan, los que pasaban por aquí, mírala. Y para los que hacen cosas como esta. Para todos vosotros, queridos amantes del pan, tenemos un Bimbo sin conservantes ni aditivos, hecho solo con harina, levadura y aceite de oliva.
¡Perfecto!
Porque no hay nada más natural que ser 100% natural.
Hello Manu, thank you. We are in the headquarters of Bimbo in Mexico with the International Relationship Management, who is Ana Sofía. Hello Ana Sofía.
Hi, good morning. It's nice to see you again. Laura, Juan Pablo. Well, according to what Juan Pablo said, when we wanted to enter the US market, we had very many barriers, but the principal ones were that the grocery store buyers wanted to dictate the lower prices. That meant for us that we weren't very profitable because we needed higher prices to like compete with the competitors, not only the US but also the international ones. Where the second one was that our segmentation of the market was the Latin American markets. That meant that we only had like this piece of the market, and that was not very high profitable for us. So it was like a very difficult time.
Okay, Ana Sofía, about your long experience and the knowledge about the company, can you tell me about the future?
Well, the predicted outcome that we were wanting to have was to be successful not only in the US market but also in the Asian market. We wanted to be very competitive, not only among the local competitors but also with all the import products from other countries. We had barriers, but I think that in the end, if we keep going like this, like having long and like very central strategies, we can achieve this, and not only that, but maybe even more.
Thank you, Ana Sofía. It's a pleasure to have you in this interview. We are going to go back with Manuela in the studio. To conclude, Bimbo is one of the largest bakery company thanks to their abilities to adapt to every market that they try to go in and to the culture of each market, and also about planning the future and thinking about their future clients. Okay guys, so thank you for coming to the show today. I hope you enjoy it, and like always, we have some bloopers of today's show that we want to show you, and we hope you to have fun in the show today. To conclude,
Manu!
Surprise for you.
Ay, no me lo goles.
The head of marketing, Laura Orozco. Okay, guys. So,
no, gracias.
And to Juan Arboleda, the representative agent of Bimbo in the USA. With only 34 employees. Juan Arboleda, the agent
Well, regarding to what Laura said,
Hello,
good morning. Well, nice to see you again, Laura, Juan Pablo. Well, today we're going to